Are you proud of your body? Or are you ashamed? Because that's how I felt for years. I used to be sort of chubby skinny. I wasn't skinny, but I did have a bit of fat, and it was kind of an awful proportion of weight on my body, and I was ashamed. I hated how I looked for years. I felt awful. But despite feeling awful, I never ever tried to make a change. I am much, much happier at my body now. But I still have a long, long way to go. I can still improve. I am much happier now, though. However, what mistakes did I make that you can avoid that literally stopped muscle growth, that halted the progress and made me gain muscle, but really slowly? What mistakes did I make that you can completely avoid? And get to wherever it is you want to way faster than I did. You see, my body, it used to be horrifying. That's quite a strong word, but I used to hate it, you know, to the point like when I had my first relationship and I was super, super skinny, I was even ashamed, like when it got to anything sexual because of how my body looked. Like, when I had a friend who had gone off and, you know, he lost his V card already, and he was telling me about the experiences that he had, and we were young at the time. Not young, young, not like that, like not bad, but okay, I'm gonna just stop talking about that now. But like, when he was telling me about it, I was like, "Aren't you scared about like showing your body?" And he was like, "No." I was like, "Oh, me neither." I was literally, it, the way my body looked literally destroyed how I felt in a relationship. That is how bad I felt. So what are the things that I did? We say you first start going to the gym, but you've been going for a bit and you aren't seeing any progress. You could be doing these things that are actually halting your muscle growth. Lifestyle. I was going to the gym consistently. You know, I was going to the gym like 4 times a week, but I still wasn't making much muscle progress. I still looked the same. Why? And it's because of your lifestyle. I was going to the gym consistently, yes, but every other aspect of my life was counteracting my progress at the gym. You may hate this already. You may completely hate the fact that I've just said this as in the first, like, the first point. And you may click off, but lifestyle does play a part. You know, when I went to the gym 4 times a week, and then I'd go home and I'd play video games all day, eat junk food, and then binge watch Netflix. All that calories that I just burnt at the gym and the muscle I just gained, I just put on all the calories again so you couldn't see the muscle that I gained. What was the point? Like, my lifestyle was basically making my gym progress nothing. So your lifestyle does play a part. Try cut down on all the bad habits that you do that are preventing you from making any progress at the gym. If you sit in and you, when you watch series, right, you watch Netflix or anime, you always have to have some sort of like sugary snack or like some sort of food, junk food. Just watch it without the junk food, because that behavior made me lose progress. Try and actually do something with your life, instead of sitting in all day and doing nothing. You know, if I compare my life now compared to when I first started going to the gym, I wake up, I go to the gym, I eat a proper meal, I then go to work, I then skate, I'll go on runs, I'll go on a walk, I'll go on a late night drive on my motorbike. You know, my life is so much more active, and you do see a lot more progress because of it. But that makes sense. If you're sat inside all day eating junk food, then yeah, your gym progress isn't gonna be there. What you put in life, you get out of life. Life isn't equal, it's fair. The effort that you put in, you will get out. And it made me really think back to like when I first started going to the gym and I wasn't seeing much progress. I had to really sit and think, okay, how much effort are you actually putting in? You're going 3 times a week to the gym, but you eat junk food and you just sit in and don't do anything active every single day. That gym progress is going to be very little. You may hate to hear this next one, but foods play a part. You may hate to hear this. You may think, oh, I can go to the gym and still eat all the junk food I want, or ice cream, or whatever it is. Yeah. No. That's not how this works. Obviously, your diet is going to play a part in the progress you make at the gym. And the more important thing I want us to understand is that there are different types of foods. And the one that's halting your progress is processed foods, such as junk food. A lot of manufactured stuff, not particularly healthy. You know, if you go into like Sainsbury's and you buy like a ready meal, like that's kind of processed food isn't gonna help. Not only that, it doesn't make you feel great either. I know a huge difference compared to when I eat pizza compared to a day where I cook my own meal. Chicken, carrots, potatoes. I notice a huge dip in energy compared on the day that I eat pizza compared to the day that I cook my own meals. I don't feel good. I lift less at the gym. I maybe won't even go to the gym. Food does play a part. You may click off. So most people would have clicked off in the first point, but food does. Your diet does play a part. Obviously, you don't need to be a complete like robot who doesn't enjoy any kind of foods whatsoever, but just try and cut down on a lot of the unnecessary stuff. And if you can, just cook your own meals. Cooking your own meals is so much better than having all this processed junk food manufactured stuff. And not only will you see a difference in your energy, but you will see a difference in your gym progress. Your physical progress. Now, this next one is kind of under the radar, and I've only learned about it recently. Well, not recently, but like, not long ago. And it's testosterone. Testosterone will play a part in the progress you make at the gym. Testosterone plays a big part when it comes to muscle growth, and I had no idea. I have a friend, right, and she's been going to the gym for a lot longer than I have. She goes to a different gym, but she's been going for a lot longer, like 3 years. And I've been going less than that, and I've already caught up to the progress that she's made. So I didn't realize that testosterone does play a really big part. And if you are doing all the good things, you know, you're doing all the good habits, you're not eating a bunch of junk food, you're going to the gym consistently, your lifestyle is active, you're not sitting in and doing nothing, but you aren't seeing as much progress as there could be, it might be something to do with your testosterone. You can search online and, you know, do a blood test or like, I don't know, a piss test for testosterone. I don't really know. It's been a very long time since I've done one, and I actually should do another one. But low testosterone will stunt muscle growth, and this is a problem that 40% of men have. That doesn't sound like a lot, but then when you think about it, 40%, that's nearly half the population. That's bad. That is very bad. So I decided to research and figure out, okay, what affects testosterone? What is the thing that most people indulge in that will affect your testosterone? And it's excessive amounts of sugar. Excessive amounts of sugar can affect and lower your testosterone. Obviously, sugar's in everything. You know, you can't avoid that fact. Sugar is in everything. It's in fruits, it's in foods. You can't get rid of sugar. That's impossible. But excessive amounts, like you have a sugary donut and you sprinkle chocolate flakes onto it, or like more sugar. Excessive amount of sugar will affect your testosterone. Adding over amounts of sugar to your foods, having a black coffee and having like 3, 4, 5 scoops of sugar, which you don't need. Another thing is sugary beverages, alcohol, drinking every single day multiple times throughout the day. I know people who drink a lot, and you know, you get the typical beer belly, yeah? So you're not only are you putting on calories, but the sugar intake from those sugary beverages will affect your testosterone too. I didn't realize it. I spent a very long time researching this, and like the more I researched it, the more I kind of like gasped, eyes open, jaw dropping. I was like, the fuck? This affects your testosterone? But I had no idea. I'm gonna stop adding sugar to my coffees. God damn. Obviously, don't try and get rid of sugar completely because that's impossible, but just try not to have super excessive amounts. And the best way to avoid that is alcohol, sugary beverages. Ever since going to the gym, ever since cutting alcohol, I instantly saw progress. Like, instantly could feel progress in my energy and at the gym. And these are three things that I used to do that I didn't really consider and kind of think about that was halting my progress at the gym. For a while, for a couple months, I was going to the gym and not seeing much progress. And it was because of these things. So, hopefully, I do really hope that this video has helped you out. I spent a lot of time researching and also from my own experiences. So I hope this has helped you and can help you avoid the same mistakes that I made. And another video is going to pop up in the corner. You can click on it if you like because it may help you too. And subscribe if you want to see more content like this. And more importantly, stay consistent and don't give up. Alright, come here. Self-improving is...